Christmas future is far away. Christmas past is past. Christmas present is here today, bringing joy that will last.
Hello, Long Beach. I'm Beverly Shields, and welcome to Tea for Two, a toast to the 20th century. This is a show in which we commemorate, celebrate, and document all of the, or as many as we can, icons of the 20th century who've been inspirational to us in our own lives, so that their memories will be preserved for future generations. I have a wonderful new guest here today. This is Jeff Freeman. Welcome, Jeff.
Thank you for having me.
And I'm so glad to have you. I've known Jeff for quite a while now, and Jeff is a very special person. Now, this show is based on a segment of the Judy Garland show, and it was called Tea for Two, and she would offer her guests tea. So, Jeff, I have to ask you if you would like some tea. Would you like some tea?
I wouldn't touch it.
You wouldn't touch it?
No, oh, I'll touch it.
Okay, you can touch. Okay, he touched it. We can at least say somebody touched my tea. Nobody ever took Judy's tea except for one person, and that was never aired, correct?
Right.
Yes, okay. And we won't tell anybody who that is. We'll let people research that on the internet. Jeff, welcome again, and thank you so much for being here and coming all the way from San Diego. Now, tell us a little bit about yourself first.
Well, I am a technical writer, and I sort of, instead of teaching directly, I teach and I work with people to train them how to do software. So I create the online help systems that people use for learning how to do the software and end user documentation. And then in my spare time, I'm an adjunct professor at National University, and I teach instructional technology to graduate students online.
That's pretty heavy duty. And you have real artistic flair. You love the arts. And tell us who we're going to talk about today. Who's the icon of the 20th century that we get to discuss today?
We're going to be talking about Hugh Martin, who people probably don't know the name, but they all know the song that we heard the introduction from at the beginning of the show, Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas.
How many of you out there, raise your hands, knew that Hugh Martin is the one that wrote Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas? And he wrote it for Judy Garland. For what movie?
For Meet Me in St. Louis.
Right. And he also wrote what other popular song from that movie that a lot of people probably know the tune but don't necessarily know all the words or know what it was from?
He wrote number one song in the country, which was the Trolley Song. Plus, wow, there was The Boy Next Door, which is a pretty popular song, too.
What year was the movie?
That was 1944, and that next year will mark the 60th anniversary of the movie. And we also say that Hugh Martin is still alive, and he lives in Encinitas, California.
He's alive and well.
And he's going to celebrate his 90th birthday.
All right. Happy birthday, Hugh. That's wonderful. And he's doing great, right?
He's doing great.
And he looks fabulous. I saw him on this video that we're going to show later.
He looks fabulous. He talks so wonderful, and he's just has a joy of life, and that makes him so special. He's a wonderful Southern gentleman from Alabama.
Really? I didn't know that. I didn't know where he was from.
From the South, born in 1914. So he has the Southern charm of the era when people were polite and people were gentle and people were just more empathetic than right. they are today, where so many are cold. He did all the arrangements for the songs in Meet Me in St. Louis that were not written by him, like Skip to My Lou and
The Bamboo Tree?
The Bamboo Tree and this little dance that he did with Margaret O'Brien. Yeah.
Right. Now, if you have not seen Meet Me in St. Louis, run to the nearest video store and rent it. Better yet, run to the nearest Blockbuster or somewhere and buy it, because it's